Hi, this is Rich with Inside HPC. We're at the Stanford HPC Conference, and today my guest is Ryan Quick. Ryan is from Providentia Worldwide. Ryan, thanks for coming on. You guys do a lot of consulting in the HPC space, but I understand your talk this week is going to be about EDA, Electronic Design Automation. Can you tell us more?
So the EDA stuff that we're doing there, you know anything about EDA?
Just a little bit, you know, designing circuits, logic paths, yeah, and such, right?
Right. And it's a weird, so it's an HPC problem in that it is, it's a massively parallel workload, but they tend to be very short-lived single processor jobs. So each job's tiny. It runs for only a few seconds at the most, because it's like calculate some small piece of work and then go away. But they may launch a 500,000 of those jobs at one time, right? So it'll be, and they'll all feed each other. So like when you run a job, it's going to be like, you know, figure out the etch surface of this thing, and it's going to feed a bunch of little micro calculations to figure out where you need to lay out all these circuits, and they're going to be like, okay, change this one thing, which will then change all this other stuff. So it's sort of this feed this whole thing. And then when you've got, you know, 35 to 100 different engineers all working on different parts of the circuit at the same time, then it's just pounding a scheduler with all these things at one time, which then feed. So you end up, you know, from a high level looking at the job scheduler, there's zillions of jobs running at one time. So it looks like an HPC workload in that it's massively parallel, lots of jobs coming. But when you bring it down at the, you know, if you tried to bring it to a, to someone trying to go, well, there's no parallel pathing here, you're not doing threading, there's, you know, from a job scheduler perspective, you're like, your jobs last 1 second and they use one core, right? There's, you see what I'm saying? But from a workload scheduling perspective, it's actually quite an interesting problem, because the job scheduler itself becomes the weirdest, most overloaded piece of the puzzle. We presented this notion of systems intelligence, I think, to set up systems using that same systems intelligence fabric technology, where we use messaging to collect telemetry from all the different domains that are involved in the EDA process to feed neural networks, which can use their recurrent structures to feed this telemetry constantly, learn from all of the data that we're feeding it, learn from themselves, and keep making these incremental recommendations to make slight changes constantly to EDA to try and get these generational uplifts over time, where we're not trying to come in and go, you know what, you need a new file system altogether. No one was going to vote for that. And we don't think that's the right thing. What we think is slight tweaks in maybe how you use the file system, or when you write to it, or slight changes to different parameters here and there. We're not going to try and make recommendations on changing out the scheduler, because you've got a scheduler that works for you, but maybe slight changes on when you use the scheduler or how it behaves is different. These are the kinds of things that we think the neural networks will make recommendations about in all kinds of different domains. And we don't know when they'll make the changes. And that was the kinds of recommendations that we thought would make particularly good behavioral changes for EDA especially. It's a very... sensitive environment, just like the coral reef. And so coming in there and, digging up a piece of coral and hoping it all settles out was not the right thing to do. And so we said, well, what's the right thing to do? We said, well, let's put something that can learn off to the side that will make recommendations that are small, and that you can take or leave as you go, and that will constantly learn from everything, but that uses the more modern techniques that we've been talking about for years, and that isn't learning from cats.
Right. Okay. Ryan, I'm really looking forward to your talk, and thanks for your time today. We'll see you real soon.